I'm at the World Health Organization on March 20th, 2024, at a meeting of on a possible treaty or other agreement on pandemic preparedness and response, talking to Barbara Stockton. And Barbara, I'd like to ask you for a few questions. I'd like to ask you to introduce yourself, tell people who you represent here, why you came to Geneva for this meeting, how you think things are going, and what advice do you want to give to negotiators?
Thank you very much. I'm Barbara Stocking, and I chair the panel for a global public health convention. This is a panel of some key leaders and ex-leaders around the world, some from politics, some from academia, but who from before we even had COVID actually, were beginning to think that we really needed a pandemic treaty. So it's a group that's is working on advocacy at a high level. It's not a local civil society group, but it's trying to take the ideas from people who are highly respected in the world, really. So why I'm here is to work out how we can help push this treaty along to deliver what we think are the right things, which of course massively include the issues on equity, countermeasures and so on, but also going back to the issues of just being prepared for outbreaks so that we can deal with them and stop them becoming pandemics. So we're here to understand what the different countries feel about it, particularly the differences between the global north and the global south, I'm afraid, often a big difference in that, and see if we can help bring some of it together to make sure that we do get a good treaty in the end. So that's what I'm doing here. And how's it going? At this moment, not well, because people are not really negotiating. They're just coming forward again. Countries are coming forward again with the things that they've said before and not really moving on. Maybe mixing it with the other question is partly that we think that's because they are going to need to have to do more work informally together to look at particular issues and to try and make sure people understand what's in them and what it would matter to them, what would be delivered by, you know, what's written, you know, sort of being there. So we think that's going to be needed. That's not really happening at the moment. It's a worry itself, because of course a lot of the poorer countries only have very small numbers of people here compared to some, you know, very big players. But we do think that actually if people could get together in more in groups that represent them, their thinking, so that we could have more informal to really try and work through and get some agreement about, you know, what's in a lot of the text. So it feels I think there's a lot of frustration in the room at the moment, but we'd really hope that we get through that and people once again remember how incredibly important it is to get this pandemic treaty, you know, basically, you know, for the health of the world. I suppose that's how it is, and that's a bit how we'd recommend it. But some of the things that we'd like to see out of it, of course, on the equity front, we want ultimately to see that the poorest countries have access from local manufacturing for their drugs, vaccines and so on. We're also very keen that, of course, prevention and preparedness for pandemics is there. And a big worry for us is just how much governments have to be involved across government at the time that these things happen. And that too often the really top leaders don't necessarily know just how dangerous an outbreak is because of the massive way that it explodes from in pandemics. And we need to get a grip on that. But the other things we're worried about is that in the treaty itself, if it comes through, we want to see compliance. Whatever is written in the treaty that says governments have committed themselves to do, we want to make sure that that's happening. Not in a blame way or any talk of sanctions, but actually so that people across the world can understand what the position is about our security against pandemics, but also help countries that you know, haven't reached that stage yet. We think that's important because it's for us. This is a treaty about the whole of society, and if we want society to be backing this, we need them to know about these things. So we need citizens, parliament, civil society, to understand what's in the treaty, but also as the years go on, how that is being delivered and whether it's being delivered, if they're really going to believe and trust in their governments and in the global governance of this. So that's why we're here trying to push that along at the moment.
Thank you.
Thank you.